Hi, AT from CNC at Home. I've had several people request my speeds and burn rates and power settings and all that for some of the things that I do, which is I'm happy to hand out what I've come across. What I'd like to talk about today, though, is how do you find that information on your own? And it's done through experimentation. What I'm going to be doing today is burning a piece of paper. Sounds simple enough. It's a thickness of paper, though, that I have not burned before. So I don't know what power setting to use for what feed rate. And so what I'm going to do is kind of start with some known information. I've got some information that I've developed for some thinner paper and some thicker, and it's not really paper, it's cardstock. So this is kind of in between those two. So what I'm going to do is kind of split the difference between those settings as my starting point. And then I'm going to do a simple test burn. I'm going to do a circle and then a square, and then I'm going to put some text on there that gets filled in. And so that's two different settings. The circle and the square are intended to be cut out, so it'll burn all the way through the cardstock. And then the text is just going to be filled in. So it's not to burn all the way through, it's just to burn enough to darken the paper so that you can read it. Anyway, so I'm coming up with two different settings, one for text and one for cutting through. And this is a 110 pound cardstock. I picked it up at the local craft store. It's something that I'm going to be able to make greeting cards or congratulation cards, that sort of thing from. So anyway, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to start with my middle ground, as I said. And we'll see how that goes. And then from there, I can determine, do I slow it down, speed it up, increase, decrease the power setting. So anyway, that's what this process is going to be. I hope you enjoy it.
To fill the letters, we'll start at 1,000 millimeters per minute at 60% power. And for cutting the shapes, we'll do 225 millimeters per minute at 100% power.
Now let's see how that burned. Okay, for the fill, we're going to run this at 2,000 millimeters per minute at 60%, and for the cutting, we're going to slow it down to 200 millimeters per minute at 100% power.
Next, we'll try that at 1500 millimeters per minute at 60% power. And for cutting out the shapes, we're going to slow that down a little bit more, and we're going to go to 175 millimeters per second, still 100% power.
Okay, let's take a look at this. That's close, but still not going through.
We're going to need to slow that down even more here for cutting out the shapes. So let's try 135 millimeters per minute, still 100% power. I think we've dialed in the text just fine, so we've got a couple burn rates for that that work well.
Oh, maybe this went through. Let's see. Almost. It's an almost through. We just need to slow it down a little bit more. An important thing that you need to do while you're testing, as you can see here, I've been writing down what I've been using for my fill and for my cut, and then taking notes. That way I can get that entered into LightBurn into my cutting library.
I'm going to get this turned down a little bit more. We'll go with 125 millimeters per minute. I'm also going to turn on the start pause to 0.1 seconds or 10 milliseconds. What that does is when it first starts to burn, it just burns in one spot for that amount of time before it actually starts moving. That helps blow through the material. Turns out not to help in this case.
Still not going all the way through. Thought for sure we had it this time. Okay, well,
we're gonna have to slow it down even more. So let's go down to 110 millimeters per minute, still 100% power. And we'll leave on that starting pause.
Okay, we'll call that close enough. Okay, so let's give this a real test now.
I'm using the dragon cutout that I showed a few videos back. I wanted something with more detail to see how these parameters were working to cut through the paper. Now I've come across a major issue with this particular type of paper. Because of its thickness and the slow burning speed, you can see that the paper actually is catching fire and burning up on the upper right-hand side there. So the only way to deal with this is to burn faster. Unfortunately, I'm already at 100% power, so burning faster isn't going to get through the material. So I've kind of run into a conundrum here.
View what happened up here. Let's see what it looks like. So what we have here is it didn't really burn all the way through. At least not enough to release the page, but it was actually setting the page on fire. I need to review what went on over here. That's not part of what's supposed to happen. Whatever happened over here. Looks like maybe it caught on fire. I don't know. We'll review the video. But, yeah, it's getting too hot and it's burning. So what we'll need to do for something intricate like this is we'll need to burn it faster and make multiple passes. I think that's what we'll have to do for something like that. Anyway, that'll be for another time.
Even though the parameters aren't perfect, I want to get them into my LightBurn library. So I'm going to set my cut-through parameters here to make sure that they're set exactly how I was using them. And then I will go ahead and do the same for the fill. One which is black at 1,000 millimeters per minute, and the other which was just dark, which was 1,500 millimeters per minute. When I went to look at this, I noticed that it was actually still set to 1,000 millimeters per minute as it had been a copy of the parameters for the black, so I needed to get that changed. I was a little confused, so I had to go back and check to see if I was seeing that correctly. And I was. So this is 1,000, this one needs to be 1,500.
Oops.
Hi, I'm AT from CNC at Home. If you like our content, help support our channel by clicking on subscribe and liking our videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have fun with your CNC at Home projects.